we should have strict rules and regulations in place because there is no limit to human creativity.
And the danger is that people may tend to believe what the computer says without actually questioning the computer.
We think we're being all super innovative and exciting and new, but we're actually building inherently really conservative machinery.
In my opinion, data is very important. Data is like the red blood cells of our, which are, you know, carrying oxygen. So without them, we cannot talk about survival. So similarly, data is the essential or the fundamental component for processing information. So it is the very seed, as we say. And if we have data, then we have some evidence in hand to make any claim, to make any decision. So without data, whatever we are saying are just our perception.
Data is being used in ways that people are not aware of. It's being used at the scale that that's hard to comprehend. And it's in many ways being used against their own interests.
Of course, some of the dangers that comes with AI is in terms of privacy and freedom. So we are having some concerns from the security perspective because we are sharing the information of people in their everyday choices that they make. Those informations are going to be fed into the machines.
A lot of where we see advances in artificial intelligence, broadly speaking, is in these ways that companies are trying to change how they interact and how they manage their customer relations. And you can see that also then now beginning to take place in how political parties or campaigns are trying to do the same thing, where that same way that you can simulate or mimic a human is being used for message testing by some of the major parties.
We don't all receive the same news. So there's a certain kind of fracturing of society. Different parts of society consume different information, which will also lead to a breakdown of a conversation within society where we all agree on a certain baseline of facts.
You can see that less and less companies and less people are able to actually access and make these decisions. And yet they have, because they can deploy at scale, profound social implications. And so what we think about is how this is being used as a new type of governance and whether that's necessarily accountable and transparent and democratic enough.
I believe the way we can be protected against those bad usage of AI is by proper training offered by, let's say, universities. There is definitely a requirement for ethics with respect to machine learning usage.
As MIT professor Fox Harrell says, all technological systems are cultural systems. Everything that we make is an expression of our cultural values.
We know that humans are subject to all kinds of biases. So these biases will probably be in the data, in the training data.
If I only give you white swans, then a machine learning algorithm will say like, okay, every swan is white. But you will not think that, oh, wait a minute, there might be a case where it can be a black swan, you know, for a lot of other reasons. It will just blindly say, well, all the images you gave me are white swans, so all those swans are white. But there is no reasoning, right? It's not like there are any hypothesis or model of the world behind. It's purely mathematical pattern matching.
So you have to be careful when you do the training on data. So let's assume you have cleaned your data and your data are of good quality, that you don't do overfitting. That is, you train so much on a very specific data set that at the end, your program is not learning by itself. There is a bias.
So another example of what is sort of commonly called AI are things like systems that they use to advise judges on bail or setting probation or even sentencing. And so these are systems that, again, pull in a huge amount of data about previous bails and paroles and sentencing, and then uses that to make a suggestion about, you know, what should be done with this particular case. And these are one of these systems that we've now found are riven with all kind of biases because the data that's used to feed them is full of bias, because the justice system that produced that data is full of bias.
Our capacity is not constrained by what artificial intelligence can do or cannot do. It's about what we should do or should not do. This is a big ethical question that needs to be very carefully pondered.
It can't do what humans seem to be able to do, which is work with past data, of course, but make intuitive leaps, use empathy to modulate their judgments, understand the intricacies of somebody's personal history.
We ourselves are so much used to, you know, dependence on AI that we may lose our own capability to analyze, own creativity, own ability to think. So over-reliance on data or over-reliance on AI is also harmful.
I think from the start we should tell kids and even grown-ups that computers are just, right now, are just dumb. And that, yes, they take decisions, but we should always think for ourselves. That's really important. We should never like take whatever the decision given by the computer as at face value and for granted. We should always question and say, you know, does it make sense? And be ready to override this decision.